Welcome to my Flat Earth Science site. I just thought I'd talk about the bit of astrology. Not that I know much about it, but I've always wanted to show how it works on the flat earth as opposed to the ball. You know, when they present the sine wave. So, like Santos Banasi and some other guys, they tend to think Earth is just one single spheroid like this, or a torus like this, and everything comes out of the center. This is our Earth, right? That's it looking down on it. Everything's sitting in the center here. This is center of creation, the tree of life that we do not see. Every culture knew about it, but modern man's totally ignorant of it, because we know better, we know best, we're really clever. We can't build a pyramid, but you know, we're really clever. More clever than the ancients. So here we have the center, and this is where they get this toroidal thing going on. Toroidal field. When they talk about the torus coming up and out. Well, see, on the flat earth, you know, in our realm, this is not us here. We don't know this. We're not supposed to. I've been showing everybody what it is. Everything in our realm comes from in here. So if you understand what's going on in there, you'll understand how you're getting things out here. Like all the projected images. You know, spinning ball is always us. Well, how come the sun doesn't shrink or change size, or the moon or anything change size? Well, the moon does a little bit. But it's because it's all a projection. Why would a projection from the one spot change its size in your realm? It's all in your horizon anyway. We'll have our own horizons, but it's not going to change its size, is it? It's not an object going far away, like a car going down the road shrinks in the distance. No, it's one projection based on frequencies. So anyway, back to what I was supposed to do the video on. This is the tropics. This is our world in here. This is our toroidal field in the tropics here. Because the tropics is the equator, is the equinox. When the sun moves around centralized, it's everything is dead level. The whole realm is equal before it starts going up to Aries, Taurus for the 3 months to the Cancer, then back down 3 months to equinox again, before going down 3 months to December and back up 3 months to the equinox again. So there's four sets, isn't it? Three up, three down, three down, three up. That's four. That's another way of correlating the four pillars. There's four in the season. But this is what the sun's doing. This is shining right out south, comes in to north. This is what the sun does, like this. And there's a video, Flat Earth Science or Flat Earth something, and they show all this, and they've figured it all out scientifically. They're showing this pattern going on. And like I've said in other videos, you've got this going on over the year with the sun, because it's coming up northern summer, out to southern summer, up again like this. That's what it does. But the moon does this every month. Up to the sun, down to the earth. Up to the sun, down to the earth. Full moon, new moon, full moon, new moon. So this is basically the sine wave here. Coming out of here, down to the tropics, under here. This is negative. So it goes positive, atmosphere, negative through the earth, and it's up there. That's the way it goes. And that's where you get the Aries. You get the Aries at the equinox. Tropics, equinox. And then you get the, this represents the equator, the equinox, through there. You've got September equinox here. So So this is working on the northern summer. So you got the summer, you got the cold. And then you've got the opposite the other way around, haven't you? Southern summer, winter cold. So the northern hemisphere is representing summer, daylight, nighttime. That's another way of looking at it. Khafre, the morning god, first kingdom. The Egyptians have told us, well, they're telling us, but no one's understood. There's the first kingdom. It's the number one. It's the primary source in the system. This is the secondary. And there's your gap. You know, electrical engineering or whatever. You've got the windings, the primary winding, secondary winding. But I think science uses this bigger one as the primary, but it's not. There's the primary, this is the secondary with the magnetic field gap. That's that gap. That's the big secret common folk don't understand. It's all about that place there. Equinox, that gap in the sky above at night, the two rotations, the gap between the southern rotation and the northern rotation, that gap we see seems straight when we see the Orion's belt go through it, but the Orion's belt is actually coming around, going around it. Moves around in there. See, this area is the ram, represented by the ram, the horns, the torus shape. In Luxor, Karnak Temple, the wide street lined with rams. It's a holy place. This is where all the mythological stories come from, in all religions. You name it, it's all about this place here. Because there's the secret, it's the gap. Just like we know in our world, it's the magnetic field, the gap between the two coils, copper coils. It's the gap in the induction motor. It's the gap in the SEG Searle generator between the magnetic rotations like this, see? So this is just like our sky rotating up here. It's what comes in between those two rotations that holds all the magic. Man hasn't figured out something. I'm not going to go into it, but anyway. So here we have it. We have a magnetic, we have this field coming up, going down, and you have the counterforce. It's high pressure coming down from the Arctics. Counterforce, the low pressure coming up, being sucked back down into here. And then we have the seasons. Up here to the winter, northern summer, down again to the next tropics. Then you got down here, Capricorn, summer down here. But anyway, it's the way it works. It's coming out of the center here at equinox. That's the beginning of time. The Egyptians had their seasons beginning at the equinox. I think they all did in the old days, back in the day. Everything began here because that's equilibrium. And then up she goes. There's the sun pointing that way through the black hole, amplifying the frequencies. All the way up, 23.4 degrees. Equilibrium. All the way down, 23.4 degrees. The Earth is not always on an elliptic, it's a load of rubbish. The maximum elliptic is down there, December 21st, or Cancer, March 21st. Otherwise it's in between. Now today, you need good photography, know what you're doing, but in reality, what's happening up there, all the celestial bodies, this is the 25th of March, they're all sitting level. They're all level in their cycle. These elliptics, it's the rotation. It's always going on, turning. All these elliptics here are level. So all the celestial bodies, planets, everything should be sitting level for a couple of days, 2.5 days, before it starts going up to Aries, heading towards the northern summer. We'll get up there, then come back down to equilibrium, equinox, September. But everything in here has leveled off for 2.2 days, 2.5 days before going starting its journey. And that was what is always celebrated. We're coming into summer, the rising of the sun, rising of the sun. And this is considered this down here, the winter's going into the underworld sort of thing. There's the winter underworld, then there's the nighttime underworld. So daylight, nighttime's underworld, summer, winter's underworld. Our Taurus is the tropics. Get all that? That's how it works on the flat earth. That is the sine wave. It goes like this. Negative, positive, negative, positive. There's something else I was going to show. There's the sun back there. This is the point here. The sun's in there. We're not seeing this. We live in this realm out here. What I was going to say about that, I'll leave it at that. But I'll just show you something else. See, most of our celestial movements have all been taken from what the Chinese had documented over the years, right? So let's say that's the x-axis on the sine wave, and we go like this. That sort of rock. And then what do you do? What do you get like this? It's more like an egg, isn't it? Not much of an artist. So what have you got here? You've got the yin and yang. Yin and yang. Haven't you? That's Earth's sine wave. There it is there. Just like that. There's the Earth. Could go on all day about that, but I won't. I haven't got it sorted in my mind at the moment. There you have it. Or looking down on the earth. You could always actually, if you work out daylight hours and stuff around the globe, at a certain time of the year, you'll get this going on. You'll get the hours working with this shape. Like if that's nighttime, and this was daytime. I did it once before. I can't remember if it was what time of the year it was. But you know, you could say that's the center of Earth here. Well, I won't go to that right now. Basically, everything in our world is sort of going like this. Because it's going up, what the Egyptians have left up is the pyramid. It's winding around the pyramid, like this, up to the sun. Full moon, new moon. This is what we're getting. If you could look down on what's going on in here, this is what you'd see down and through there. I mean, we see a reflection up through here, because if you imagine a vortex water, you know, always turning, and whatever's down there is being reflected up here, all you're going to see is a circle like this. Because they're going to be fading in, fading out, because they're fading out as they go down around behind the other rotation. Because you've got a rotation. Yeah, rotation basically there like this. the wind's going to be coming in and going out. And this is what we see in the Polaris rotation. Just like in the southern rotation, we see the same thing coming in and going out, because they're moving on out of your horizon as this moves around the flat earth. So you can mention the sun's in here. You've got a cosmic egg in here. And everything works its way down and up. The sun, the moon does, up, moves up past all the planets, because the planets are spaced out here on their tracks. Looks up and down. So this is what we see in our night sky. So I'm not sure, I haven't got a good camera, but or telescope, but you know, most of them, it's probably like that, but at the equinox it should be more like that, but it depends on how this reflection comes down to our sky. But if you could see the whole sky in one night, I would think it should look like that before it starts going aphelion or perihelion. Perihelion. And we're getting all this out in the perimeters, out here. Another reason why they think we live on a spinning ball for some weird reason, I don't know why, but that's the system. If you're looking down on there, that's the system. So if you've got, so you've got a planet out here, and they reckon there's moon, like let's say it's Jupiter, moon moving out there, then moving back. That could just be, you've got this area going on here, but you've got all the background stars. That could be any star right here. We're seeing from here, doing something. There's plenty of other options than just focusing on a spinning ball. We don't live on a spinning ball. So people just need to think about it. Stop just being stuck in the mud with the spinning ball theory. It's a load of garbage. So this is the moon. It just tracks around, down, all the way down to full moon, and then winds back up again. So everything is moving the same way. It's just up and down, up and down, because the strong magnetic field in here. Science knows about that. That's how you form plasma. It's the sun and a strong magnetic field. And the rodent coils in that, they've got magnets, balls, steel balls, just suspended. Then they've got like a rodent coil, and they put a ball magnet in there, or just metal, and it's just floats there, because it's locked in that magnetic field. That's what the sun's done. The sun is doing in there. It's how you form plasma. And it's all projected out into our realm. Nothing's out there in La La Land. Guys, I still don't believe this fact that this is turning. Yet I've shown it. I've shown how it works. You get your time lapse photography and you see this one rotation. You see it there, you see the rotation. It's always moving. Actually, it's in here though. Around the northern rotation. The southern rotation is always moving around here. And you text this in star trail photography. And the fact, if you take a circular like that, there's a southern sky, and follow one star, you get that swinging out of a star. Science knows you get that, and they think they relate it to the fact that the Earth's turning and it's on the elliptic angle and this garbage. But realize the fact that Earth is not always on an elliptic, that the equinox is not. It's only maximum 23.4 degrees when it's at the Cancer in December. Well, that's about it. That's all I'll say for now. Cheers. Thumbs up if you like it. More questions? I'm open to questions.